I'ma be
on the next level. I'ma be rocking over that bass treble. I'ma be chilling with my mother crew. I'ma be making all them deals you wanna do. I'ma be up in them A-list flicks, doing one-handed flips, and I'ma be sipping, don't trip, cause I'ma be shaking my hips. You gon' be licking your lips. I'ma be taking them pics, looking all fly. I'ma be the flyest chick. I'ma be spreading my wings. I'ma be doing my
do it.
Okay, I'ma swing it this way. I'ma swing it that way. It's Fergie Ferg, and I'ma be here to stay. The 21st century till infinity.
I don't know why I am recording in 30 degree heat in two layers, but it's all for that video. It's inspired by Emma B. It's a very funny animation video, and the link is in the description if you want to watch it, because it was really funny and I got inspired to do this video's dance for it. Now if you excuse me, I'm going to change it to something a bit more cooler. Oh gosh, it's hot. Do I smell something cooking? I smell cookies. Or maybe it's just the cooking bodies of British people as they can't handle 30 degree heat. Hi guys, it's Nominomnoms, and oh yeah, so if there's a little bit of tapping in the background, my sister's here. She can be my welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you can see from this title, I'm going to be talking about a range of things, but mainly about Coco Pops, because this year's just been an interesting year. Like, you know how videos have tags? If 2020 had tags, along with the virus that cannot be named because you could get demonetized, even though I don't have enough subscribers or views to get demonetized.
Plus, you would use copyrighting videos, you're not gonna get money anyway.
Okay, then I could just use it. COVID, the other tag that 2020 can be used, that is used in 2020, is cancel culture. And just literally, it started off with Ellen DeGeneres, how everyone realized that she was a bit of a B. Now it's gone so far to like, finding the tiny little things. Anyway, this is just my opinion on it, but I'm going to be talking about Coco Pops. I've got my notes, give me a sec, let me read it. Okay, so let me just tell you how this started. A while ago, like months ago, I think now, I was sitting in the living room and my dad came up to me, showed me an article saying something about a former MP called Fiona Onasanya. I don't think I said it correctly, but I will not talk about her because she's another topic because yeah. Anyway, she said that Kellogg's Coco Pops mascot is racist. Now, I was hurt. I was offended. Like, my childhood mascot. I ate Coco Pops every day when I was a kid. I shouldn't have, but I did. I was fighting back. I was like, no, it's not. Anyway, it was quite interesting because I didn't exactly know a lot about, I don't know a lot about Kellogg's. I didn't really look in their background, so I was defending something that I don't know its history of.
I'm leaving, this place is too damn hot.
Okay, so where was I? Okay, so I was offended because I saw this as my childhood mascot. I saw nothing wrong with it. It was just a fun character. I was a child. Why would it be racist? But at the same time, I don't know much about Kellogg's to back it up. So I started researching, and what is the best place to look for a topic? Wikipedia, and then check its citations. The first information I got, obviously, is the BBC article about how Fiona claims that Coco Pop's monkey, Coco the monkey, is racist. In other words, she asks Kellogg's why Rice Krispie has three white boys and Coco Pop is represented as a monkey, hence why she just claims the brand as racist. Okay, from the tweet, most people were ridiculing her because they ain't white boys, they're elves. Come on, did you not see the ears? And also because most people didn't associate the monkey with black people. I still don't associate them with black people. I'm trying very hard to associate them because I'm really good at overthinking. I thought it was just a fun mascot for kids to like join in because the primary audience is kids. Like, you're not going to show like a boring businessman representing Coco Pops. A spokeswoman of Coco Pops mentions that the mascot was created in the 80s, highlighting the playful personality of the brand. And the spokeswoman mentioned that they also added tigers, giraffes, crocodiles, elves, and even a narwhal on their cereal box. So hence backing up the idea that there is just, they use a range of fun characters to attract kids. So I was like, okay, this is from the article, but I need to look further back because there are some brands that still have upsetting racial history behind it, such as Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben. So who knows what if, I don't know, Coco the monkey has some sort of racial past that I don't know about. Okay, let's start with the history. So Coco Pops is also known as Rice Krispie in places such as US, Brazil, Colombia, Spain, and Germany, but UK has Coco Pops. We tried to do Coco Krispie, I think in the 90s, 1988, but sales drops, and after a phone vote, 90% wanted Coco Pops back. I think there was even an advert for this.
So the great name debate. The nation is voting for either Choco Krispies or Coco Pops. Here are the results.
This cereal shall be known as Kellogg's Coco Pops!
Well, a magnificent victory for the Coco Pops party. At last, sanity has returned to the British breakfast table.
Kellogg's Coco Pops it is! Thanks for voting, everyone! Yay!
Okay, I'm going off topic. The first cereal arrived in 1958 with the mascot being a monkey called Jose. I'm assuming it's called Jose because the mascot was quickly changed to Coco the elephant not 2 years later after the Mexican-Americans took huge offense with this character. And usually when you say Jose, it's not really Jose, it's Jose. And it's quite impressive because the best way to summarize how this offense was so bad was from this quote from Evil Squirrel 13. They said, "You have to utterly fail hard at designing a mascot that has successfully decried as racist in an era when people are still drinking from separate water fountains. If it's that racist during a time where we had to separate people by color, you done fucked up." Coco the elephant didn't last long either. I don't think it had to do with any racial reason. I think it's because they wanted someone more recognizable. Because after Coco the elephant, they moved on to a well-known character called Snagglepuss. So Snagglepuss came in 1963, and I believe they were owned by Warner Brothers. But not long after, the mascot was yet again changed to a caveman called Og. It has one O, so I'm guessing Og. So that was changed in 1967. And to tell you the truth, Og can audition to be my sleep paralysis diamonds because those adverts were not pretty. I hated them. And once again in 1973, Kellogg's changed their mascot. Like, this is just America, not even UK. We haven't even gone to UK yet. But they changed their mascot into an elephant called Tusk. And I have nothing to complain about it except the fact they had bananas on the Coco Pops. That just makes them the Hawaiian pizza of cereal. Like, why? Why? Anyway, so we had Tusk the elephant. He kind of looked like a smart elephant due to like the glasses and everything. He did have glasses, yeah. Kind of had that kind of feeling like, oh yeah, let's have this nice, sophisticated breakfast. But yeah, Tusk the elephant, that was it. He stayed until 1982, so that's just 9 years, and was replaced with the three little elves we know and love today. Snap, Crackle, and Pop. Compared to like the first Snap, Crackle, and Pop, they've changed a bit. In 1961, that's when UK was introduced to Coco Pops, and we had Mr. Jinx. This was the same time around Snagglepuss, so I think they were also both part of the same studios, I think Warner Brothers. But later on, Mr. Jinx was replaced with Sweep the Dog, which is more known in Britain. And I think I have a very small memory of watching Sweep the Dog because he looks nostalgic. I think it was to attract more kids from Britain because it was more locally known in the sense that it was a British kind of theme character. Okay, and then in 1963, Coco the monkey was created, and that was it for UK. Okay, so America had Jose, Coco the elephant, Snagglepuss, Og, Tusk, and the elves. So they had six changes. Meanwhile, we had three. Even though we had Coco the monkey, he has changed various times over the span of his career, lifetime, till now. Ultimately, Coco the monkey mainly sported a white shirt with his name Coco on it and blue jeans. I'm not going to go through like deep in the history, look at the whole charts of like what Kellogg's were thinking, seeing their thoughts and all sort. But from the looks of what I've gone through, I still don't understand why Coco the monkey is deemed as racist. I kind of find it more annoying that Fiona assumed that the monkey was associated with black people, even though it had no kind of connection at all, apart from it being a monkey, and monkeys are from Africa, but there are also monkeys in any other countries. Why? Like, there's monkeys in Asia, there's monkeys in South America, there's monkeys everywhere. Why would you assume just Africa? I found it annoying that they linked it with black people. Kind of like how the recent JoJo Siwa incidents with that little girl dressing up as a monkey and they assume it was blackface. Compared to Jose, Jose was problematic. Jose is a popular name in the Latin American community and the Spanish community. So to name a monkey called Jose, you can kind of see the links, but Coco, it definitely doesn't associate with like African or black community. And the attire does not absolutely like connect to any community. It just seems like normal clothes. Anyone can sport a white t-shirt and jeans. Now obviously Coco the monkey has to be from somewhere, and based on the adverts I've watched, and I've watched a lot, it seems like he's from Africa. Like they have safaris, they have like obviously you've got jungles are everywhere, but usually safaris are connected with like African kind of jungles and such. I assume they are from Africa. I still don't see a link between African people. They're just African animals. Why would you assume they're African people? I still don't get it, Fiona. Please explain to me in more detail. You probably won't even see this video, but like... And even though they are in Africa, they have so many adventures all around the world. They're in like the city, which I assume is New York. They have adventures where they do football. Heck, they even do sci-fi. They do sci-fi, like I think it was like Go to the Moon series. If you want to see a link of the whole like adverts in order, I found a really good video. It is quite a series, you see there's a lot of plot twists. The rivalry is intense as well with Coco the monkey and the crocodile. And with the adverts as well, well at least with the UK adverts, Coco the monkey has a British voice actor. If it was an African accent like Nigeria or like Zimbabwe or Ghana or anyway, Then I can see where people can be like, oh, this is racist. You associated this monkey with an African person. So Fiona was only mentioning about Coco the monkey, which I 100% think, until I get more information, that Coco the monkey was not seen as a racist move on Kellogg's. Sure, they had other problematic mascots, but Coco the monkey, absolutely not. Do you assume that there are people from the 50s still working in Kellogg's apart from like the higher ups? I don't think so at the moment. I don't even think the majority of people will probably accept such a problematic thing in the world we live in now. But apart from Coco the Monkey, there was one other controversy. So in 2017, Coco Pops US, they released an advert with all these like Coco Pop characters. I think it's Rice Krispie. They were all golden anyway, except from this one character who was darker than the rest and was a janitor. So every Rice Krispie in that picture, except from the janitor and the security guards, did not wear any clothes. And out of all of them, except the janitor, were all light golden kind of color. I was like, oh, maybe it's the shadow. But then when you look at the picture very closely, it still didn't make any sense. It wasn't technically shadows, they were Rice Krispie's clothes. And that was a bit weird. I was like, How did it get so far to be released? But luckily US Kellogg's quickly shut it down and like, oh my goodness, we're so sorry. Because corporations. Still confused why it got so far to being released, but they got it down and I'm a very forgiving person.
Hi guys, I'm on my editing mode and I realised that I don't want to talk about the other topics that I put on. So I was just going to focus on Coco Pops because it was already long enough. So it probably sounds a little bit weird from this point onwards because I was talking about other topics. Excuse the background as well. But yeah.
Okay, I'm tired. There's nothing else to say. At least I know that Coco Pops mascot, it's not racist in my thoughts. Okay, if you like this video, like it. you have to, because I said so. If you want me to talk about more stuff like this and me getting confused and upset by it, give me some suggestions, give me some stuff to research about. Description, DM, that, bye.